The Major Arcana. Tarot cards present the reflection of DNA laws of our universe and life of every person follows these laws. Every moment of these laws is determined in its own stage and energies. The Fool. The journey begins from an unburied card. Arcana from the moment when newborn baby sees this world, he can't understand anything, is pure without any fear and takes his first steps into his life and starts his own journey. The Magician. The first of Major Arcana is the time when the little person starts making his own choices, takes the will into his own hands, appear his first desires, first intentions, projects. The Higher Priestess. The second arcana, the stage when a person must learn when his mind calms down and he is ready to accept new information, gets concentrated and remains in deep reflection. The Empress, the third of Major Arcana, in a first Arcana, the person becomes an active adept. In a second, he gets the knowledge, and in the third arcana, he gets real results already in corporeal level. The Emperor, the fourth arcana, the authority, is reached as a result of effort. The Hierophant, the fifth arcana, respiration, superior knowledge, intuition, and meditation are being mastered. The Lovers, love, the sixth arcana, is related with frequency of love and always means that a choice must be made between higher love or earthly love. The Chariot, the seventh arcana, it is an active motion forward and usually it means a journey. Justice, the eighth arcana, truth, verity, justice. The astral police is blinded. Justice always takes the place. Doesn't matter if someone thinks that nobody can see him. Anyway, his bad deeds will bring bad results and his light will bring the light. The Hermit, the ninth arcana, tells us that the real light is inside each of us, not outwards. Wheel of Fortune, the 10th arcana. Human's life is full of changes. One day you are on top and next day you are down. Only stationary point is the state of higher self. The only way to stop falling and rising again and again and stay stable is one point is to get into your center, into your higher self. Strength. The 11th arcana. It is our destiny. Only mastering our mind and senses, we can master our destiny. Only when it becomes gentle as a cat, pouring on one's knees. The Hanged Man. The 12th arcana is a time for adaptation. Only by learning to adapt yourself, passing through suffering and adjustment, the astrology can be mastered. Death. 13th arcana. It is transformation and rebirth itself. Temperance. 14th arcana. It is time when forces gain balance and great results come. It is like a touch of solar genius. The Devil. 15th arcana. These are our own weaknesses that are hidden in a mind and brain of every person. The expression of ego. The Tower. 16th arcana. Catastrophe. Collapse. The circumstances that we can not control. But remember, always collapse the things that no longer serve to our evolution. The Star. 17th arcana is a purpose, the real path, fidelity, higher love, healing. The Moon. 18th arcana. We face visible enemies like a wolf and invisible ones that stand behind our back, such as a hyena. Some of them attack straight, the other speech in secret, and the only way to avoid them is to focus on truth and light. Only when these enemies can no longer catch up with us. The Sun. 19th arcana. It is a time of depths, get relief, completion and perfection, time when come the best results and the light. Judgment. 20th arcana. Justice, rebirth, resurrection. Much like the phoenix rises to a new life. The World. 21st arcana. Universe. When a person in his life journey masters all the elements, he just needs to wish and everything happens. At the same time, he knows his place on earth, in the universe, and does what he must do. He has fully discovered himself. He is in harmony with the whole universe.